This video is sponsored by SVBONY.
This is not a simple filter, this is a variable polarizing moon filter, which means you can change the intensity of the filter according to your needs. Let's see if it's worth it, and later in the video I will show you the test with a camera. Will it work? Who knows?
After a busy week, we all deserve an enjoyable weekend to leave all that stress behind. Me and my family chose to go to the beach. The sky looked promising for the night with a telescope, if it wasn't for the moon. We saw it when we passed through this castle and we took this beautiful picture with a smartphone. "Daddy, can we see the moon tonight?" they said. "Of course we can," I answered. And now I knew what to expect for tonight. There's always something magical about the moon, which attracts us to look at the sky. So I placed my 8-inch Dobsonian telescope outside, inserted an eyepiece into it, and when the time has come, I called the kids. Guaranteed fun. Although as the moon is so bright, we always have a problem with the eyes.
Ouch.
It's too strong and quickly turns our view all white.
And my doctor picked this filter from a book she had to watch the moon without hurting her eyes. Incredible. We also tried with color filters, like these ones I have, but they changed the color. I didn't like that. Actually, I like to watch the real color of the objects in the sky.
I can't wait to try this filter also in planets like Venus. I will upload that experience in the future.
Even in EAA astrophotography, I don't like to change the colors. I prefer realistic views. Let's solve that right now.
Today's sponsor, SVBONY, has a large number of products available. They sell telescopes and its accessories all over the world. They have this variable polarizing filter there, and you can also find their products on Amazon. We made a deal and the filter arrived. Having a nice and clean aspect and feeling like quality building materials, we can attach it directly to the eyepiece. And some of you may be thinking, after insert the eyepiece into the focuser, I will have to take it out if I want to readjust the intensity of the filter. Well, no, if you use the trick I will show you in a moment.
This variable polarizing filter can be used turning the both sides of the filter, so you can manage the intensity of the filter. Almost black. And a bit brighter. See? One side or the other. If you have a low profile focuser, it will depend on your focuser, and you have also an adapter like this, an M48 adapter. After attach the filter, you can attach the adapter, and as it has a ring, it will stay like this in the focuser. But like this, you can watch the moon if you have focus with this, turning and adjusting the filter intensity, just turning the eyepiece. This will make your visual observation of the moon more comfortable. But of course, you can also use the regular way without the adapter, and you take out the eyepiece and you adjust before you watch. And another tip, if you can manage to use an extension, you can attach it, the filter, to the extension. Adjust the intensity you want for that night, and then you can change the eyepieces without having to touch the filter again. Great! And I will tell you a secret.
You can use this filter with a camera.
This is a real live view of the moon using SharpCap software without processing anything. I'm using the ZWO-294 camera for this. This is just for you to see how the filter performs. I'm using the same trick with the adapter, so I can change the intensity of the filter just by rotating the camera. I don't recommend dog using this trick with a camera, because we have a USB cable attached to the camera and it will inadvertently cause the camera to rotate. You are watching the filter in action. This is a stronger position of the filter, which turns all darker and sharper. Now look what happened when I rotate to the brighter side. It gets too bright. Nonetheless, we can use that position during other phases of the moon. That's why I love this variable feature. And now let's compare the image capturing the moon without any filter. And this is what we get. So now my children can watch the moon without hurting their eyes, and we improved the quality of our night sessions with this variable filter. Overall, a very nice filter, bang for the buck, and check this video over here if you want to know more about filters. They can be powerful, I do loads of tests with them.